This is Lucy. You're listening to Heat World Saturday on Heat Radio. Olly Murs
What's
is here
happening?
With me.
Heat World Radio Saturday.
Does anyone call you Oliver?
Some people do. My
your mum when you're naughty.
Caroline used to call me Oliver on The Extra Factor a lot. Oliver! My mum calls me a lot.
But it's Olly.
It's Olly, yeah. I mean, I don't know, yeah. I mean, I don't know where I came up with the name or the idea of it. I just...
just flowed.
Someday, I think I heard someone call someone Olly one day and I thought, that sounds quite
nuts.
Cool. I'll take it. I'll nick
now,
it.
Now, you are... I mean, I've been reading lots of stuff about you breaking the states. Do you feel like you have broken it now?
No.
Don't you?
No. I don't think it's... I mean, it's great that I've sold 1.2 million... record sales on Troublemaker. I mean, that's a pretty cool statistic. I'm happy
with
that.
Do you still have to pinch yourself?
Yeah. I mean, I do pinch myself sometimes. I don't know.
Not in that
reasons
way.
For, but yeah. No, to be honest with you, you know, breaking America is a massive thing. I think just one single doesn't make it a massive success. I mean, it's great and I've got that now under my locker, but I think it's about proving that success and having another hit single over there and keep building on it. I mean, 1.2 million record sales for this country for a single is huge.
Yeah.
Over there, it's nothing. It's peanuts.
How much money you got in the bank?
What, from that single?
Yeah.
I won't get it till next year.
Oh, won't you?
No, you won't get it for like 6 or 7 months ahead.
And what are the girls that... like, do they shout at you in the street? Do you get recognised now?
Not in America, no. It's actually quite, for me in America, it's actually quite relaxed over there. I quite enjoy it because I can just walk around, do my own thing. No one really cares.
Whereas here...
the old Ned Kelly's hanging out. No one gives a poo who I am.
Whereas here, what do they do then?
Oh, God, I couldn't walk down the street without someone going, oh, my God, is that Olly Murs? He's a bit fat, isn't he? He's got a bit of a belly.
Did they say that?
Not really.
How do girls react to you?
Well, in the UK?
Yeah.
I think everyone's really nice, really respectful. I think it depends where I am. If I'm out in a nightclub, it's a bit different to what it'd be on a normal work day if I see a girl on the street. But
Do they get amorous in nightclubs?
What does that word mean?
Means do they get a bit loving and suggestive?
I think so. A few drinks. We all get a bit loving and suggestive when we get a few drinks down. I think that's a natural thing for us. We can't help but flirt when we've had a few drinks.
What kind of things do girls say to you? And is it weird? Because do you think...
I've had a few... what's the word? Offers. A few...
Yes.
What is the word?
Obscene offers.
Obscene offers.
Like what?
I can't possibly tell you.
I know it's Saturday morning radio.
I can't tell you on a Saturday morning. No, I mean, it would be a case of... where are you going after this? Because I'm coming with.
Okay.
And I'd be like, I don't think you are, but appreciate you offering.
Have you taken anyone up on the offer?
No. I don't think a girl coming up to me and asking me that is a good thing. It's like, okay, so you do want to ring up the newspapers now and tell them this is going to happen? Because I can tell them if you want. So no, I don't really, that's not really my style. But no, I mean, it's fun though. It's good fun. I mean, and it's fun.
And in America, because obviously you were there a lot with One Direction.
Yeah.
Were there any famous American women who were attracted to you?
I would probably say no. I don't think they really know me yet over there. I mean, I'd like to think that maybe Mila Kunis thought about me maybe once or twice since Graham Norton interview. I'd like to think that she maybe thought, do you know what, that Olly Murs was a nice guy.
Did
when
you tweet
I
her afterwards?
I didn't tweet her afterwards. I don't think she does Twitter.
Because you tweeted Gerald Cole once, didn't you?
I asked her for a number which got completely custard pied. I only did it as a cheeky way and a bit of a joke. But no, I mean, I think American girls do like the English guys. I like the accent. It's like if an American guy comes over here, like a Justin Timberlake or a Bruno Mars, and you're just like, all the girls are like, oh my God, his accent's amazing. So I think in the UK, I mean, in America, the UK accent does go down well, but I've yet to see the benefits of it yet.
And what was it like with One Direction? You're really good mates with them anyway, aren't you?
Great guys. I mean, you know, what you see is what you get with them lads. They're cheeky, they're good fun. You know, they give me a great opportunity in America to do the tour with them, which was brilliant. And they're good guys.
Did you get up to any naughty antics?
Not really. No, America's a tricky place for the boys because obviously a lot of them. They're obviously, you know, they're under 21, aren't they? So I think you can't really go out and club and drink over there really because it's a bit difficult because they're too young. So, but I'm sure there's going to be lots of antics in the next few years when they get a little bit older. So. But yeah, I mean, not when we was on tour, no.
Who's got the best body out of One Direction?
The best body?
Yeah.
I don't
Who's
know. I've never really
works out the hardest?
I've never really
They're
checked them out in that sort of way. But I think to give you, I think I'd probably say Liam's got a good physique. I'm sure.
Okay.
I think you'd be interested in seeing Liam's pecs if he got him out. Yeah.
All right. Nice. And obviously, Tulisa is not on the judging panel anymore. Were you surprised?
Yeah, a little bit was, and I mean, I mean, me and T get on really well, but I you know. Obviously the decision behind that, whether it be the X Factor or her decision, I don't know what she would have been feeling at the time, but I think personally I get on really well with T. She's a great person, she's funny, she's a great laugh. I mean, we've had some great times in the last 2 years going out and having a drink, and she's a great person. So I hate when people just jump on the bandwagon and say things about her, and all the press now are like, you know, this and that about her. She's great. She's
what
top,
should she
top
do
girl.
Next though, because Caroline said to us the other week that she thought she should do Strictly.
Well, that's what Caroline said.
Well, why not?
I don't know with T. I mean, I know she's very much into her music. She's great at producing and all that sort of stuff and writing music. So I'm sure that she'll be probably getting involved with that with maybe the N-Dubs guys again or...
I'm a celebrity. Maybe doing... Would she go on that, do you reckon?
I don't really know. I mean, I think, to be honest with you, she's a very interesting person and she's got a lot to talk, you know, she's got a lot of
she'd
stories.
She'd be great on that.
I mean, I suppose she'd be a good person to find out a bit more about her. But and I think what you see is what you get with T. I mean, you see everything anyway.
Do you fancy her?
I think most guys would say Talisa's pretty hot, yeah.
Yeah.
But I mean, we're just good mates, so I've always told her that she's hot.
Have you?
Yeah, all the time. Talisa, come on, you're hot. I mean, God, I remember once we was in Greece. And I remember Tulisa was there and Caroline, both in their bikinis. I was like, man, this is amazing. And you know, we're having a break in the sunshine in Greece and I've got Tulisa and Caroline in the pool in their bikinis. This is amazing.
Are you loved up at the moment?
I wouldn't say I'm loved up, no. I mean, I've been dating and different things. I mean, problem with me is I've been away pretty much since Christmas. I haven't been home, so it's pretty difficult to sustain any kind of relationship with someone. But
is there one? See.
I wouldn't say there's one, no.
Oh, there's more than one.
No, but it's not, you know, I think, you know, my life is the way it is. Yeah. It's just a bit crazy and a bit full on.
You love it, don't you?
I do love my life, yeah. I think if you don't love this job, I think if you don't laugh and enjoy this job, you probably cry because it's you know, we get everything. We get, you know, the extremes and everything. We get the extreme trolling on Twitter. We get the extreme, you know, adulation of our music comes out. We get told how rubbish it is, how great it is. I mean, everything's a negative and a positive for this job, so it's you just have to enjoy it. How'd you spell your
what
name?
What do you do with your tongue then?
I was just gonna go like that.
Why?
I don't know why I just did it.
How do I spell my name?
I shouldn't be showing you my party techniques.
No, you shouldn't. Lucie.
Why the IE?
I don't know. That's what I was born with.
Was it actually your...
Yes, I didn't. Oh. I didn't do it like a showbizy name.
Are you sure?
No, I'm sure. You can ask my mum.
Okay, well, ask your
my mum Carol. And
ask you Carol because some. See, I get told some people spell my name. Even now, some people in interviews, I'll sit on like an auto cue or like on cards or even on the iPads.
Yeah.
My name is spelled Olie. I'm like, it's on my CD cover as Olly.
I know, but they don't read.
Idiots.
Maybe they can't read. Anyway, I've got a few questions for you. You may recognise these from Heat magazine. They're called, ooh, that's a bit personal.
Ooh, that's a bit personal. Yeah. Ooh.
Right, quick fire questions.
Yeah.
How much money have you got on you right now?
Oh, I have nothing on me right now. But I think in my wallet I have 35 quid.
Okay. Who did you last receive a text from and what did it say?
I last received a text from Chris Kamara. Do you know Chris Kamara?
I know the name.
He's off Gillette Soccer Saturday.
Oh, okay. He said that
he saw me on a TV show in the mornings. I said he likes my new song, Dear Darling.
Nice. Well, will that lead us into Dear Darling in a minute?
Sweet.
When were you last naked in front of another person?
Yesterday when I was getting the fitting. For my up and coming TV shows, I was naked in front of all my team.
Okay. What do you dislike most about yourself?
My hair.
Why?
I don't know, just never liked it. I'd like to change it.
What was the most embarrassing moment of your life?
I think it was probably when I just nearly slipped down the stairs on the Alan Carr show recently. And
you slipped down a few stairs.
Starstruck next to Alan from Hangover. That was weird.
He was good, wasn't he?
I was so embarrassed.
What or who has been the greatest love of your life?
Greatest love of my life? I'd probably say Oh, wow. This is a big question. My at the moment, my biggest love of my life. My mum.
Yeah.
Of course.
Nice.
Mum.
Body hair, wax, shave or leave?
Leave.
What do you smell like?
I smell like, I don't know. Do you want to come and smell me?
Yeah.
You come and smell me.
Let me lean over. Hang on.
What do I smell like?
Kind of, it's quite fresh.
Fresh.
Fresh. Okay, Olly, it's time for you to leave me now.
Oh, it's time for me to leave your gorgeous studio.
Yes, it's beautiful.